What's happening, Discovery Wrestling? It's me, the guy who usually draws the raffle with the huge announcement regarding the future of Discovery Wrestling. For the last 10 years now, we've prided ourselves on bringing the very best in independent wrestling to Edinburgh, whether it be showcasing some incredible homegrown talents or bringing in international superstars. For us, it's always been about the wrestling, and it will always be about the wrestling for many, many years to come. Things may have seemed pretty quiet since November, since the Friday night disco in Portobello Town Hall, but that doesn't mean we haven't been busy. We've been incredibly busy preparing for not only the new year, but a new era for Discovery Wrestling. And while people talk about new eras all the time, this truly will be something very, very special for Discovery. And I'm not just going to sit here and tease you with the details. I'm going to tell you right now that this new era for Discovery Wrestling will begin February 9th, Portobello Town Hall. And this will be a Friday night disco like no other. Because yes, you can expect the biggest names from around the UK to be there. You can expect championship matches. But you can also expect a brand new championship to herald in this new era. I'm very excited about what's to come. And this new championship, it's just the start of what's happening here in Discovery Wrestling. If you want to find out more about what this new era means, then you need to be there at Portobello Town Hall on February 9th. It will be an incredibly special night for me, for Discovery Wrestling. February 9th, Portobello Town Hall. Keep an eye out on all the socials for all the details. Tickets will go on sale this week. It's a brand new era for Discovery Wrestling, and it starts February 9th.
Happy New Year! Can I still say that? It's February 5th when I'm recording this. Welcome to All About the Disco. I'm your host, as always, Billy, as we bring you the preview to upcoming Discovery Wrestling event, which is this Friday, Friday Night Disco at Portobello Town Hall. Now, usually I would be here trying to show you some tickets, but the show sold out. It sold out as of Sunday, so I can't really do that. So what I'm going to do is go through the rest of the show and tell you what's happened and let you know. If you haven't already been to a Discovery Wrestling show and you want to go to the show and you've got a ticket, this is going to be your first time, hopefully I'll be able to provide you some backstory, back information, and a little bit of a preview of what to expect at Discovery Wrestling Friday Night Disco. It's going to be a new era for Discovery Wrestling, as you heard Alan say at the top of the episode. I'm looking forward to finding out what that new era entails and looking to see what we'll see a new champion, perhaps. We don't know. I mean, things can happen in pro wrestling. We do know there's a four-man tournament to happen at the event for the Scottish Open Weight Championship, which we'll talk about very, very soon. So, there's matches announced. Let's talk about them. So we're going to kick off this preview here with Casey defending the Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship against Emerson Jane. Emerson Jane cashing in her Disco Derby win with the title shot for this title to get the title back. It's a title too many times. To get the championship back that she held in 2017 for 483 days. Very interesting to see that Emerson had decided to go to the women's division with her victory at Disco Derby, the last final two being her and Zach Dynamite. Thinking that possibly we would see Emerson Jane try and challenge for the Y Division Championship against Gene Money. But it's not to be on this occasion. We're seeing Emerson Jane take on Casey. Now, these two have fought frequently. These competitors have been against each other on numerous occasions, whether it's been in Discovery Wrestling, whether it's been elsewhere around the country, around England, and everywhere else. So they've got a lot of history. They know each other quite well. I would be happy to stake my claim on that statement. Emerson Jane is fresh off a win at TNT DOA, so winning a death match tournament on Saturday, and then she won the tag team titles at TNT, the TNT women's tag team titles with Rio on Sunday. So she's been prolific at the moment, has Emerson Jane, with deathmatch wrestling, fighting at GCW as well over in the US, and getting a lot of praise for her deathmatch antics. So she may not be coming in at 100%. That's the long and short of it. She might not be coming in totally 100%, might still be a bit banged up from the Tournament of Death, or the DOA tournament at TNT this past weekend. So she's coming in with some bags, some scratches, and everything in between. Casey, one of the She-Wolves, are going to hunt on that. She's going to find the blood, find the weak spot, and go at it against Emerson Jane. I'm just interested to see the logic behind Emerson's decision to go back to the women's division, and when that title opportunity was for any division that she could have went for. So very interested to see if the risk's worth the reward, when she's going to become the first ever two-time Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion. Casey's reaching 800 days as champion. I think she will be 800 days when this episode goes out. So she's a long time champion. She's been able to. She only defended it a couple times in that time. Discovery Wrestling only run about maybe five shows a year, so she's been able to defend the title a couple times in that 800 day span. But Emerson Jane will be coming to try and reap the rewards and use that Disco Derby catapult to try and get the title back, and like I say, become the first two-time champion. Very interesting contest. Like I say, these two have a lot of history with each other. They'll be very familiar with each other as well. We could be in for a fantastic match, and we might just see a new champion. We might not. That's the beauty of wrestling. We don't know what's going to happen. But it's Casey versus Emerson Jane, Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship, setting off the new era, on a high, I'm sure. Second match announced on the show, well, we've got two matches announced along with the tournament, as Will Cruz returning to take on Joe Hendry. Of course, TNA's Joe Hendry, much like Emerson Jane, who recently appeared on TNA last year, I think it was. It was Impact Wrestling at the time, of course. So Joe Hendry, who last time he appeared in Discovery Wrestling was the Impact Wrestling Digital Media Champion. He defeated Jack Morris to retain the title. That was back in Livingston in June 2023. He's had a little bit of a step back from Discovery, thanks to the good times costing him the Discovery Wrestling Y Division Championship earlier at the start of the year, as well. So Cruz made his last appearance in July 2022 at Tagged, taking on Caleb Valhalla. I feel like I'm incorrect, and they could be in the Disco Derby, but I know what this is how we do the podcast. I'm gonna go check because that's just how we do here. So Disco Derby, let's have a look. This is fantastic content, I'm sure, for people that are listening. I could edit it out, but that would be the fun of it. So back in July 2023, I will say, yep, Will Cruz was in the Disco Derby. My apologies for my incorrect information. So Will Cruz didn't make an appearance back in July in the Disco Derby, which saw Emerson Jane win that match and get her number one contendership match. So there's a lot going on here. There's a lot going on. We've got Will Cruz looking to possibly try to stake his claim back into the Y Division Championship picture. He had that match All About the Raffle against Gene Money, when Gene wasn't the champion, but it was an Iron Man match, which Gene was able to be victorious 2 falls to 1. So he wants to get back into facing Gene Money. Joe Hendry, I'm sure, will be wanting to get back into the Y Division title hunt, after the good times cost him the title earlier in 2023. So there's a lot at stake, perhaps, in this match that hasn't been said or hasn't been written down that we could see play into be a factor in the match. The good times are in the building. Perhaps we've got matches in a tease has been requested by Skull Brawl, so good times may be in the building. We'll be interested to see if Joe Hendry, if that's a distraction for Joe Hendry, if we could see him maybe be off his game when he knows the good times are around, when he's looking for a little bit of revenge against the faction. Will Cruz, big guy, big agile guy as well. But Joe Hendry has fought big guys. He's been able to lift and throw very heavy set men. So that's something that Joe will be looking to combat with his speed, with his strength against Will Cruz, with his sheer mass, and also got that deceptive agility as well. So a match that's going to be, I think it's going to be one that you watch and go, ooh and ah, when you see the feats of strength, the agility of Will Cruz with Joe Hendry clashing. It's going to be, I think it's going to be a nice one. It's going to be maybe a little bit of a dark horse stealer, show stealer for this particular event, this new era of Discovery Wrestling.
When we do the videos, anything can be here.
Anything.
Any world you want,
like
any video, whatever you want.
Like a portal to another realm.
Well, yeah, I'll be a kind of.
Sorcery.
Yeah, so we'll put someone on there.
Can the mighty Gale control it?
Yeah.
Yeah!
I'll show you how to do it afterwards, right? Okay. We need to film this thing first.
Oh, okay. Oh! What's that music? Anyway, new era of Discovery Wrestling. You know what that means, Sorcerer Rastin?
Tell me.
It means the mighty Caleb has his eyes on the kings of the north.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Or something else we need to deal with first. Look, it's a new era, okay? We've got old scores to settle with the good times, yeah. Not the bald one, Mr. Mandibles. Mr. Manival, okay?
You done goofed!
You did done goof. Okay? Now, boys, this isn't over. You beat us down in Livingston. We tried to get our own back.
I threw Manival.
You did throw him.
I threw him. Two groups.
And the referee threw the match out. So, you know what? This is just a wee message for Discovery Wrestling's new management. New era. I don't know how things are going to go, but what I'd like to ask is if we can do Skull Brawl against the good times one more time for the number one contendership to the tag team titles, and then we can take on the Kings of the North and bring the belts back to Skull Brawl.
Now, before I get into the tournament, I haven't actually said yet. Doors open 6:30 p.m. First bell 7:15 p.m. It is sold out at Portobello Town Hall for Discovery Wrestling on Friday, February 9th. So if you've got a ticket, amazing. If you don't have a ticket, you're going to have to wait, find out results, clips. Hopefully, they'll put out some matches in the near future as well for Discovery Wrestling. But before we get into the tournament, there was one match that's kind of been teased. I don't know if it's going to happen. It's been requested by Skull Brawl. Lost by Aspen and Caleb Valhalla. They've asked for a match against the Good Times, Rob Stowe and Monstrum, a number one contendership match against. So the winners face the tag team champions, Kings of the North. Whether it's going to be in the near future or on the show itself, we don't know. The match hasn't been made official as of recording, so it could be a case of it may not happen. It may be set for a later date. But all we know is that the Skull Brawl have made the challenge for a number one contendership match against the Good Times, where Mr. Manival will be skulking at ringside. I'm very much sure of it. So these two teams have not really settled anything. They've had their brawls. Disco Derby kind of escalated things, and then Party and Porty in November, there was a no contest because these guys just couldn't stop brawling. So there's a lot to be settled here, and nothing's really been set in stone of who's got the advantage over the other. They're just two teams. They're just fighting. This is weird. It could go two ways here, because it likes the Skull Brawl. We saw Aspen and Caleb brawling with each other constantly, and then they formed this kind of weird friendship to form Skull Brawl. But on the other hand, these two teams are just brawling with each other and causing chaos. So we'll see. I don't think friendship's on the cards anytime soon between Monster and Rob Stowe, with Caleb and Aspen. So yeah, don't think that's going to happen. But we could see a tag team number one contendership match. Kings of the North are on the poster, as you can see there. There. Damien Corbin and Bonesaw. So they could be in the building. They could be looking to pick up the pieces, whoever wins that particular match. So, yeah, plenty intrigue and interest coming out of that match. If it happens, like I said, it's not been announced, it's not been official as of recording. But I'm sure there'll be an announcement soon to confirm. But the show is sold out. So if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, I'm sure it's still going to be an incredible show nonetheless. So well, let's get into the tournament.
Discovery Wrestling fans, this is Joe Hendry here, and we told you that on February 9th, Discovery Wrestling is going to crown a new champion at Portobello Town Hall. But it is now time, right now, to unveil what that championship title is. I'm very excited. The title has arrived, and it is now time for you to feast your eyes on the Discovery Wrestling Scottish Open Weight Championship. Look at this beautiful championship title that we have to showcase today. This is so exciting for Discovery Wrestling. Look at this beautiful belt. We're going to reveal what this division means, why it's been brought into Discovery Wrestling, how it relates to the other divisions, and all the information. But for now, let's just check out how beautiful this belt is. As you know, Discovery Wrestling is all about the wrestling, but it's also synonymous with Edinburgh, so we wanted to include some of that on this championship title. Check it out at the bottom, etched into the gold, we've got the castle, and at the top, we've got Arthur's seat and a saltire across the middle. Also, these parts at the bottom here and the sides are heavily influenced by the Attitude Era title, and that is a purposeful decision because we wanted to give the feeling that, you know, wrestling's at its best when anything can happen, and that is a feeling that we wanted to bring to this division and to the company.
So Joe Hendry revealed the title belt, the Scottish Open Weight Championship, a beautiful belt. He's explained in our little video the reasoning behind the design of the title. So for those watching the video, you'll get to see it. For those that are listening, you'll be able to hear the description of the etchings and the design of the title itself. The Open Weight Championship is going to be a four-man tournament for the Scottish Open Weight Championship. And it's a very interesting list of competitors we've got here. So we're going to start off with Andy Roberts. So Andy Roberts is coming off a loss to Gene Money at Party and Porty over the Y Division Championship. Last win in Discovery was in April against Chris Ridgway. So it'll be just interesting to see where Andy stands in this, because he's had lots of chances for titles in Discovery Wrestling, tag team titles, the Y Division Championship. He's had plenty of opportunities. He's won tournaments before in Discovery Wrestling, like the Hotter Than Hell Edinburgh Invitational. So he can win tournaments. He can get accolades in Discovery, but it seems to be titles are the things that's eluding him. He's a kind of UEWA European Heavyweight Champion as well, so he comes in with some title experience, plenty of title experience, in fact. But he hasn't really had that much title success in Discovery. Out of the four competitors that I'm going to go through here, he's easily the biggest. He's the heavyweight in this open weight chapter of the tournament. So it's very interesting to see where it goes from, where if he can outlast this four-man tournament. Like I say, absolutely possible. He's done it before in the Hotter Than Hell Edinburgh Invitational, but whether that will translate, because things have changed since then. That was what, 20, I think it was 17, something like that, 20, it was a while ago, at the very least. Things have changed for Andy. He's no longer Andy Wilde, he's Andy Roberts. He's got a change of mentality. He's the sports entertainer now. There's things have changed. And whether that means he's got a one-track mind over the title, absolutely, that could totally be the case. Or whether the things are bigger now for him, things like Power Pro, things like UEWA, European Heavyweight Championship, these things are taking up brain space and pressure space that this tournament might be a little bit too much. That's an absolute possibility. I could be rambling absolute nonsense at the same time. So that makes it very, very intriguing. Probably a favourite in the tournament, just due to sheer size alone. And the having that Sherman tag with Ferrari engine, is that what they used to say for Husky Harris, aka Bray Wyatt? So yeah, could be a favorite. I think, I mean, any of these four competitors could viably walk away with the Scottish Openweight Championship. If you go to a tournament and there's definitely one dud, that kind of makes the tournament nonplussed and don't need it. So any of these four competitors could walk away with the title. Next up, Liam Slater, whose promo, whose little graphic was, I mean, I did get a wee laugh with it because it's just the back of his head. But his last appearance in Discovery, I've got noted, is December 2017 in a loss to Kenny Williams. No wins on main shows. He won a pre-show match against Uncle Bobby, I think it was. But since 2017, Liam Slater has really ramped up in England, especially. He's recently fought Jonathan Gresham at Wrestle Carnival. He's a former North champion, North, who are just like blowing up right now in England, certainly across the border. A lot of great things seem to be happening down in North that people should be probably keeping an eye on, I think. With a win over Joe Hendry in North as well, I think that was late 2022. So, as a former North champion, he's got definitely got the accolades as well. Liam Slater is quickfire. He's going to be a dark horse, possibly. Put him as down as the dark horse in this particular match because we haven't seen him in Discovery Wrestling for a number of years now, and it just means that he has an unknown quantity in this tournament. An interesting pick to throw into this tournament. Like I say, his win-loss record in Discovery itself isn't great. 2-1. One win, two losses. But it doesn't mean anything when it comes to the tournament because anything can happen in pro wrestling. That's the point. One of the marks of the Scottish Openweight Championship was that little bit of a design throwback to the Action Era Big Eagle belt with the little flares round about the side, round the top and the bottom. And to give that anything can happen mentality. And Liam Slater coming in, let's say, has been Discovery since I've got noted as December 2017. It could just mean that he is that unknown quantity, he is that mystery that could come in and steal it all and take away the title at the end of the day. So, interesting choice.
And action! Oh, Jesus Christ. Take two. Discovery Wrestling returns to Portobello on February 9th to start a new era. And a new era means a new belt, the Scottish Openweight Championship. Now, they're going to have a four-man tournament to determine the new champion. But I have a slight issue with this.
Just like a small issue, like a little one, he's really little.
And no, my issue isn't the fact that Liam Slater's English. And no, my issue isn't the fact that I won more matches than Andy Roberts last year. You see, my issue is the fact that the first person announced for this tournament was Ian Skinner. Someone who I'm currently tied 1-1 with on the scoreboard. In fact, I even stole a poster from the last show where I beat him. See? Signed and everything. So Discovery, what I'm trying to get at here is, I want him. Okay, bye-bye.
One person specifically requested entry into this tournament, and his name was Judas Gray. So Judas Gray, very charismatic wrestler. We've seen him doing a lot of charismatic things and enigmatic things, not only in Discovery Wrestling, but around the country. He requested entry, and very interested, he requested it. Just considering who the last person is I'll be speaking about in this little section. So, his win-loss record Discovery, not great. To be honest, he won entry into the Disco Derby. He qualified with that, with a win. But his last match was against Emerson Jane at Party and Porty, which he lost by submission. But again, you can't be downhearted about losing to someone of the caliber of Emerson Jane. So, yeah, it's not all bad. But we go into that, he requests entry to the tournament, and he got it, he received it as well. They take a couple of days, some working days, like we're still waiting for Skull Brawl Good Times to be confirmed. And it takes a couple of working days between the request and the entry on that case. But Judas, again, another one that could possibly just rattle through this tournament, this four-man tournament to win the Scottish Openweight Championship. There's no argument for me to say that he absolutely cannot. He's got a little bit of a swagger. He's able to adjust and adapt. He's fearless as well. And if he's coming up against the likes of Andy Roberts, or likes of someone of the experience of Liam Slater, he's not going to show any fear. Whether that translates into making an unnecessary risk, maybe. But we do know that Judas Gray will show no fear in this particular matchup when he's going up against the possibilities of Andy Roberts or Liam Slater, or the last person in this tournament that's been announced. I think he was the first name, perhaps, as well. So last person I'm going to speak about in this tournament is Ian Skinner.
Discovery Wrestling! I know I like to laugh and joke and have a meme, but this is something that means a lot to me. And if you're entering this new era of Discovery Wrestling with us, I welcome you in. My name is Ian Skinner. I am Mr. Consistency. I put my heart and my soul into every wrestling contest that I'm a part of, and yet championships have eluded me in Discovery Wrestling. But now, the Scottish Openweight Championship has a four-man tournament that night. February 9th, the new era of Discovery Wrestling, and therefore the new era of Ian Skinner. All my trials and tribulations of the past, they've been learning curves. I'm learning from them, and I plan to progress upon them. Because this new era means that I'm coming in with fire under my belly, lead in my fists, and I'm ready to kick ass unlike I've kicked ass before. I believe, much like in Everything Everywhere All at Once, in every universe, the first Scottish Openweight Champion is Ian Skinner. Let's make this new era together.
Now, I tried to pair these two up, Judas and Ian, the last back half of the preview, because what we know, Ian Skinner has been around Discovery for a little while now. His championships have not really been forthcoming for him. I don't think he's had that many opportunities either. He fought Chris Ridgeway for the Wrestle Carnival Pure Championship, but I don't think there's been that many title opportunities that have come to Ian Skinner. So this is one of the first times he's really got to zero in onto a title opportunity. He's got unfinished business with Judas Gray, and from what the information I got from Party and Porty, the challenge was made from Ian Skinner to Judas Gray the next time they met, it would be a 2 out of 3 falls match, because Ian Skinner still got plenty to teach Judas Gray, and Judas has got plenty of lessons to learn. So, fantasy, armchair booking here. I'm in my chair here. I've got the armrests up. Could we see Ian Skinner, Judas Gray in the final? And will, in that case, due to the pre-existing agreement, will that make the final 2 out of 3 falls match? If that is the case, then these two guys, if they make it to the final, I'm not discounting Danny Roberts and Liam Slater here. If these two make it to the final, I mean, this could be an opening round match, but if they make it to the final, there's the potential that we're going to see 4 falls, that these guys will have to go through 4 falls. Their opening round match, or their semi-final, and the possibility of 3 falls in a 2 out of 3 falls match. If there's one way to cement yourself as a champion straight away in Discovery Wrestling, when it's all about the wrestling, is to go through that kind of trial and tribulation to walk out with the Scottish Openweight Championship. Like I say, these guys may not meet in the tournament. One may be eliminated in the semi-final. These two may face in the opening round. But if we're looking at the prospect of these guys going into the final against each other, Ian Skinner and Judas Gray, then the potential of a 2 out of 3 falls match, if that is the agreement that was made back in Party and Porty, makes it all the more tantalizing, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Judas hasn't got that far to travel to get to the show. This is something that I'm always very, very focused on when it comes to when I'm seeing who's announced for shows. Ian Skinner has relocated. He put out a video. He's relocated to Yorkshire. And the opportunity seems to be coming his way. Coming to North, he's debuting in a lot of companies in England as well. The British wrestler now, Ian Skinner. So will that influx of opportunities drive him forward, drive him to become the champion, or will those influx of opportunities mount more pressure on Ian Skinner? That's possibly something that Ian I mean, we've seen Ian Skinner enough to know now that you don't quite know what's going on in that brain of his. He is probably one of the most fascinating wrestlers in the country. And now he's a British wrestler now, but he's one of the most fascinating when it comes to trying to get into the mind of Ian Skinner. He's got those wide eyes that just you don't know whether he's going to hug you or stab you, you know, that kind of way. But coming into this tournament, I personally think, I mean, seeing that Andy Roberts should be a heavy favourite, I'm going to put somebody on Ian Skinner. I think Ian and Judas as the final as well is, like I said, tantalised prospect. Are we going to see it 2 out of 3 falls? Are we not? That's the intrigue. That's the beauty of this new era in Discovery Wrestling is there's going to be some chaos. There's going to be some anything can happen atmosphere, prospect. And something like this, Open Weight Championship Tournament, new title. Discovery Wrestling are very seldom when it comes to titles. They take their time. They like to build a division to before they bring a title into the stake. So to see these four battle out for a beautiful title as well as Scottish Openweight Championship, this is going to set off this new era with a bang, along with the other title matches, the other title match that's scheduled for the show. I'm looking forward to finding out more about this, and I'm hoping to be at the event in April. So whoever wins this title, hopefully I'll get to see the belt live and in person in the next couple of months. But can't wait. Along with those matches, like I said, there's 2 matches announced at the tournament, possibility of a number one contenders match, tag team match, but we don't know. It'll be official as of recording. Ravy Davies set to return to Discovery Wrestling. I think it was 2018 last time he appeared, along with the Discovery Wrestling tag team champions, Kings of the North. Well, they're on the poster, so I assume they're on the poster. So I assume they are going to appear in some sort of capacity, whether it is going to be regarding the number one contenders match that may happen. Who knows? Also, before we go, it's a sold out show, so I can't really go get tickets. But if you want to find out more, go to discowrestling.com and you'll be able to find out upcoming events. Like I say, I'm hoping to be at the April event as well. I'll finally be able to get, after 10 years, be able to see some Discovery Wrestling live and in person. But Friday, February 9th, Royal Bell Town Hall in Edinburgh, Discovery Wrestling present their new era sold out show. Doors open 6:30 p.m. First bell, 7:15 p.m. Also, all that information, the edinburghwrestling.com, go to the Training Academy information. If you want to become a wrestler and you're in Edinburgh and you want to train under the likes of Joe Henry, Alex Emerson Jane, like a Lost by Aspen, you go to edinburghwrestling.com. You go there, they've already set up seminars for the likes of Mike Bailey, Speedball Mike Bailey, and Veda Scott, guest trainers, and they've got 2 classes as well, 2 locations. Find out more, go to edinburghwrestling.com as well. Well, this has been all about the disco. I think it's been quite a svelte episode because, like I said, there's 2 official matches, tournament, and a potential tag team match that we've got on the cards to, on Friday for our Friday night disco, a new era of Discovery Wrestling. Looking forward to finding out what happens. I'm looking forward to getting the results and finding out more and checking out the social medias as you can. Tickets are sold out, so you can't get a ticket, but keep an eye on social media as tickets may become available if people are unable to attend. Go to Discovery Wrestling, find out more, and you'll be able to hopefully get yourself along and find out more about this new era in Discovery. But in the meantime, this has been Billy. This has been All About the Disco. Hope you enjoy yourself. Hope you go enjoy your Friday night disco. And hopefully, like I say, I'll see you in April. Fingers crossed. Have a good one.